Hi, in this video I'm going to have a look at the new features in King of Avalon version 7.2 that was just released. One of the probably main new features is the Nidorfall. It's a new event, might be a replacement for Nidorwar, I'm not completely sure. I don't know anything about it yet, I'm not playing the beta, so yeah, I will make a new video on that once I get a chance to play it. Another major new feature is the new set of hero weapons. So this is the Wildfire set, and there's a significant increase. So the purple of Wildfire is 57.52, the earlier level was 30, and the infantry bone cavalry boost are 172.57 at purple, and the previous one was 90, so that gives an indication almost twice the amount. What you do need, besides some tiers of ascension, is a new type of scroll, Wildfire Ascendant scroll. I did get one from the Honor Pass, and you will probably get a couple from the Honor Pass, but you need to spend if you really want to get be able to craft these weapons, or wait a long time until they make it available for non-spenders. There are a couple of related things that are mostly interesting if you are a spender. There's a Time Lord targets for your hero weapons, but I didn't get anywhere there, and I haven't spent anything, so point wise. So have a look at that if you are a big spender. Maybe it's a chance to get some extra rewards. Normally gold is all the rewards you can get here, but still could be interesting if you have already spent. The other thing is it's basically the normal things. There's now a Heroes Crucible, but actually it's at Heroes, but it should be Hero Weapons Crucible, because only stats from your hero weapons function. I didn't get further with the weapons you just saw. I didn't get further than the third expedition, so still the first stage. So that's a bit of a pity for me. Maybe others, likely you needed to have spent for this, you'll get further. That is actually the normal thing. Oh yeah, there's a Merlin trial. There are two new chapters in the Hero Merlin trials. So that's not nothing surprising there. Another new event that will be there is the Thanksgiving Feast. This might be something we've already seen before, I don't really remember. I think we once had something with turkey, so maybe that's it. Probably not so special, just a way to get some extra rewards. If it is something very special, I will also make a separate video on that. For the Kingdom Raid, they have added rewards for Alliance Leaderboard, Kingdom Leaderboard, and Alliance Points. So that actually is quite nice. I find it quite interesting. I cannot show that to you yet. I assume it's self-explanatory, otherwise I will dedicate some video to that later, or maybe mention it in one of my regular videos. The Royal Arena has adjusted bonus attributes from the Master ranking. Haven't really looked at it yet. Probably not that interesting. There are some other more interesting things. From the Trial Shop, you can now, the Merlin Trial Shop, you can now get some Celestial Statue Arcana. I hope 7 in 2 days, although I don't know whether that could also be 7 days. It depends when the time down. When I started, it was less than 2 days, so I'm hoping it is 2 days. So that would be quite nice if that is possible. But could also be any other number of days. And from a number of events, there's now Hegemony Inkot and Celestial Statue Arcana available. So that's quite nice. For the Excalibur Invasion, the individual rewards, you now have some Hegemony Inkot. Here you already did have the Celestial Statue Arcana. The others might have some, like I think the Light Arcana has moved up to a lower level, so that's quite nice. The Ultimate Alliance Conquest. as now for the individual rewards, also some hegemony ingot and celestial statue arcana, and some other rewards have also moved to lower levels. I think the scrolls and the light and chaos arcana, so that's quite nice. You also get some infernal statue arcana here, which is also still quite nice. I'm not sure whether the amounts have stayed the same, especially with the Nidor War. It seems to me they are a bit lower than they used to be, but I'm not completely sure about that. So here you can get a smaller amount of Hegemony Ingot and Celestial Statue Arcana and Infernal Statue Arcana. But I just have the feeling that the Light Arcana amount here is smaller than it was. One thing I haven't checked, I think, is the Demonic Siege. That still looks the same. Okay. That's it for the changes. It is very nice to get Hegemony, although it will take some time to get the 100 for a full piece, but it is definitely nice that you can get it via this way, and maybe there will be other ways that it will be a bit easier. And the Celestial Statue Arcana is a big improvement over Infernal Statue Arcana. It also requires actually less statue material, so that will be quite nice. Let me have a quick look at it. To illustrate this, so you get 45% for the Infernal, and that cost 29,600 statue materials, and then this one costs only 4,000 statue materials, and you get 74.81, so that is a huge difference. And considering that you can multiply that with 4, the improvement is very significant. But the thing is that you do need 200, so I already have 145, but you need 200 for this of this Celestial Statue Arcana. Okay, that was it for the things I've noticed. If you have seen other things that's always much that have changed or that are new, that's always much appreciated if you can share that. Will be useful for me and for others, and thanks for watching this video.